Good evening, everyone. I'm Ryan Bradley, Clean City Coordinator for the City of Reading. And welcome to Our City, Our World. We have a guest with us tonight. Her name is Guillelyn Medina. She's going to be talking about some initiatives that she actually brought to her own community, and also the Sixth Ward Block Party / Festival that we have coming up later on this month. So, Guillelyn, how are you doing tonight?
I'm doing good, Ryan.
Okay.
Thank you for asking.
Okay. So tell us a little bit about yourself, and I need for you, because I want to know myself, I need for you to talk about what made you want a stop sign at Second and Buttonwood?
Yes. So the reason for the stop sign was because a lot of people can agree that it's a high traffic intersection. And there was no stop sign on Buttonwood Street. There was only a stop sign on Second Street coming out. As myself, living there for 20 years, we've seen a lot of accidents happening in that corner, especially when it comes to myself and my children walking just crossing the street. There's always an issue with the car speeding, not stopping for us to cross. So the last time that I saw an accident, it was really big. My mom was almost at the corner, but luckily she was crossing the opposite side. I just got fed up. I was just like, you know what? That's it. We need something here. Why isn't the city doing something? So I asked one of the officers that was there in the scene, and he told me, all you got to do is just do a petition and get some signatures. I said, okay, how do I do the petition? He goes, go to the library and get it filled out, and then that's it. I'm like, okay. So I took the initiative to get some signatures from the community, the neighbors, the homeowners that's been around there for so many years. And with me getting the signatures, a lot of people were saying, oh, they're not going to do anything. I'm like, well, we'll see about that. So I got 70 signatures. And on the Monday of the city council meeting, I went in and presented the petition to the city council. When I told them my story of why I need this traffic light or stop sign in this corner, they all agreed. Like, wow, yes, I agree, because I even drive down that street, and it's a high traffic because of Buttonwood Street Bridge being there. So from there on, they understood my complaint, and then a year and a half later, we got the stop sign.
So would you agree that intersection was like it was a detriment to our environment, to the environment there?
Yes, because there were kids coming out of school. Even though there was a crossing guard there at the corner, the crossing guard even had an issue with cars stopping for him to let the other kids cross. Even when the crossing guard is not there at a certain hour, you know, kids coming out from after school
right.
programs, they have to cross. There's an issue there.
Right.
You know,
right.
So
how long has the stop sign been up now?
It's been up since the last 2 Decembers ago.
So about 2 Decembers ago. So there hasn't been any accidents there?
We seen just one.
Okay.
And it was just a minor.
So would you say that the stop sign has made a difference in that environment?
Yes, tremendously. Even a lot of people, when I tell them that I was the one that put the stop sign in there with the petition, they say, oh my goodness, yes.
Thank you.
We need
it.
Thank you so much. Right. That was really necessary to have that. So
Now let's talk about the your involvement with that community in general. I know that you adopted a part of Buttonwood Street as part of the initiative, the Reading Adopt a Block program.
Yes, I did.
What made you want to get involved with that?
Well, my mom lived there since 2002, and then I bought my home in 2014 or 13. Yes, 13. And just knowing that this block is my block because I've been there for so long, I wanted to feel like I'm doing something different.
To actually keep it clean, right?
To keep it clean because of it being such a high traffic, even with people walking to the Dollar General, which is at the corner, it's a lot.
So how often do you clean the block?
I clean it once a week.
You clean it once a week, okay. Yep. Okay, and have you got any help from any of your neighbors?
My husband helps me out, thankfully for that. There are some people that stop me and saying, hey, what are you doing? Why are you doing this? Are you working for the city? I said, no, I just live here and I want to keep the block clean. Okay. And they would say, wow, thank you so much. You know, if you ever need any help, I'll help you out.
Okay. Right. So do you feel a difference, with the block being, because I ride by there myself and I see, I notice, when you have your orange bags out and I ride through there myself, do you think the neighbors feel any different? Does that part of the neighborhood feel different since you start cleaning it?
Yes, tremendously, because every time I'm cleaning, I have a neighbor saying thank you. Thank you. There's even like a couple of houses I can say that are abandoned. Nobody would clean it. And I would be the one cutting the grass off and taking the trash that's under their porches, And so it gives it a beautiful feel that my neighborhood, my street looks clean. It looks refreshing.
Okay.
Every week.
Okay. So now let's go back. So you went from a stop sign.
Yes.
To adopt a block.
Yes.
And now this is the second annual.
Yes.
Six Ward block party that you're having.
Yes, it is.
How did that come about in the first year? How did you start doing that?
So because of the block part. Because of the stop sign, when Johanny Cepeda Freites was city council for the 6th Ward area, she loved my idea when I presented that to the city council. So I went to her, we set up a meeting, and I said, wow, if I ever get a stop sign or a traffic light in this corner, I want to celebrate it, period.
Okay. So getting a stop sign was more like a celebration.
Yes.
The block party was a spinoff to the stop sign.
Yes.
Okay. And what type of activities did you have the first year?
So we had two bouncy houses that I had a friend of mine's donated. I had the Goggle Works was there. I basically just invited the community, the organizations that's in that community,
because
it's so important to us.
Right.
So the Goggle Works was there. I had the Reading Water Authority was there. The Reading Police was there. Burst Community Health was there. The Opportunity House was there. Lars Park represented. And we had the fire hydrant open
from
the mayor.
Right.
And I had a couple of churches from the area. Feet on the Street Ministries was there. They had performed. And I had friends from Spring Valley as well. And on top of that, we had gave a bonus to the people that had signed the petition to come out and sell, like do a yard sale or do a cookout so we can all do something together.
Okay. So what type of things did the Goggle Works, like what type of activities did the Goggle Works offer?
Oh, she had some bubbles and chalk and art and this one game thing that you put on the kids' faces and they can see from like an out of this world thing.
Mm-hmm.
They had all the kids like try it out. So that was a pretty cool thing that they did.
And what about the other resources? Like you mentioned, of course we know the Water Authority, they had the Water Buffalo there, but like whatever fun things that they have there for the kids that involves the environment.
Well, we didn't have so much because of one thing is the temperature, last year when we did it, it was in the middle of July, and the temperature did go up to 109 degrees.
Okay.
A lot of the community did not come out because of that temperature, but we did have some that was in the block seeing that there was something going on out there. So they came out, we all got wet in the sprinklers, and the kids were just having fun. We had people giving out free food, you know, to the community, and the kids was on their bikes. So it was really good to see that our block is open for us to have fun in it.
Okay, so now this year, you know, me myself being a committee member, can you give us an idea like what type of organizations will actually be there this year? And what I like about it is a lot of the organizations that are coming out are organizations that offer, you know, services, you know, to our community. And I'm a firm believer that, you know, a lot of people don't know about a lot of services that we have.
Yes.
So I know that when we started meeting, like we started putting together, you know, some organizations and see if they can actually come out to offer the community what it is that they have.
Yes.
So, yeah, go ahead.
So I have a list of people because I feel like I don't want to leave anybody out when it comes to this. So for food vendors, we have Cocina Salazar, Fortuna Kings, and Tojitos and Aguas Mas, which is right there on 2nd and Walnut. They're the Colombian restaurant, Mo's Pizza Shop, Southern Style Kitchen, and Cafe Esperanza. For all the educations, we have Opportunity House, the Reading Film Office, the Performance Group, the Village of Reading, the Reading Public Library, Berk City Democratic Association, Planned Parenthood, the Fire Safety, BCAP, you yourself with Public Works and Adopt a Block, RAC, YMCA, RISE, Feet on the Streets, Arrows Christian Academy, Johanny Cepeda will be there, the Migrant Program, United Way, Moravia Health, Union Baptist Church, Yes We Care from Holy Trinity. So those are the educations. Then we have activities that's happening with the Boys and Girls Club, Holy Cross, the Million Youth Chess Club, Latin Fusion Baseball, The Forge, RHS Cheerleaders, Hope Dance Studio, Star City Boxing, and for entertainment, which is the high mark of this event, because we are going to be having a stage and entertainment that's going to be performing. We have WH Dance Academy, Houdini Music, he's going to be the DJ, Goggle Works, Joel Delgado, magician, Barrio Alegria, face painting, Hope of the Nations, Spring Valley Church, Oak Street Health, The Real Deal, and Carlos Cruz from Hope of the Nations as well.
Okay, that's a healthy lineup right there. And like I said, I like this idea and I like this concept because, you know, we talk about our environment, right, and the way that we use spaces in our environment, and I believe that, you know, bringing people and into this space, especially, you know, we know it's going to be clean because that's what you do.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And bringing people into the space to enjoy a day and have, you know, organizations to come out, you know, to offer their services. Like I said, and I always say this a lot, you know, when I talk to people at events like this, like it's a lot of, you know, a lot of organizations in our neighborhood, in our city, that a lot of folks don't know about.
Right.
You know, so to have a block party and for organizations to come out, you know, rather it be mental health, rather it be education, whatever it is, you know, something for our kids, you know, 610 Real Deal, you know, they have great services that they offer also, you know what I mean? So for them to come out, you know, and people to come out into the community, you know, I think that the block party, you know, and really like how the concept started from a stop sign.
Yes.
You know what I mean? You know, just to bring the people together, you know, everybody to come out just one day, no violence.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Just peace and love. Peace and love, you know, like for one day. So is there anything else that you want to talk about when it comes to that?
Just a little bit. I am basically, you know, I was born and raised in New York, and I've been here since 2001. And one good thing that I was brought up with is, you know, in Harlem, New York, I was in the dead center of the Harlem Week block party. And every time when I would wake up in the morning and hear the music going and the food, you know, cooking and loud people, you know, talking and stuff, that gave me that amp, like, ooh, let's go outside. Now we can walk out in the streets and, you know, get the feel of, like, nobody can stop me now,
right,
you know?
Right.
I'm bringing that aspect from my childhood here in my community. So that was my vision in the beginning of how I wanted to happen because of where I came from, you know, and having that feel, because it was always amazing.
And having a clean community, you know, is really priority.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Having a clean community is really priority. Well, if you don't have anything else, that's it for this segment. You got something else?
Yes, I do.
Go ahead.
I don't know if we even told you the date of this event. September 23rd is the date. It's a Saturday from 12 to 7.
Where?
At Lawrence Park Elementary. We're going to be blocking off 2nd and Buttonwood all the way down to 2nd and Walnut. So we're going to have two long blocks that's going to be blocked off. So I'm hoping that we can get the whole community out and have fun together. We have like 50 plus organizations that's a part of this. And I want to thank everyone that is signed and finalized their commitment to being a part of this and just wanting to do something good inside the community, not just on Penn Street or at a baseball field. And those things are amazing, but let's make it a block party in our own neighborhood. So that's what I'm doing.
Okay. I appreciate you. We're out of time. I'll see you again next month. And remember, it's our city and it's our world.